You have claimed that Muhammad is an intercessor on Judgment Day.
Yeah.
But Muhammad, by his own very words, but has said someone who invokes curse cannot be an intercessor.
God, there are general rules and then there are exceptions to the rule.
No, we understand that.
No
Muhammad,
problem.
Muhammad, we understand that. Show us that this is general.
That's it.
And show us that this is not specific.
No, no, no. If you don't let me speak, I'm going
to
go.
We're giving you time to speak to over there 2-3 minutes. The only time that Jerry gives you another minute. And you're still waffling.
I want to ask you a question.
What are they going to ask about, you know?
Okay, what you can
murder,
do is, you can do
training. Apostasy.
Let's talk about apostasy. Are you scared?
What are you talking about? Child marriage.
You already know
I'm giving you a clue. See if he's done his homework. Okay, what's your question, my friend? We're going to talk about Muhammad.
No.
You're on prophet.
You're asking me what you want me to talk about.
Yeah, but this is our question.
Yes.
Our question is, how can you follow a prophet who cursed people and who also is a sinner while your hadith says that Muhammad did not come to curse or invoke curse on people? How can you follow a prophet like that?
Well, I mean, it depends on how you define curse. Because the hadith that you're referring to, there's different words for curse, la'na in Arabic. You know, sometimes people need to be cursed. Allah curses on the Quran. In the Old Testament, Jehovah curses the people. He invokes curses upon them. Many people have been cursed. I mean, I don't see a problem with that.
Okay, so why does Sahih Muslim, for example, 3260-283 say, Darda reported on the authority of Abu Darda as saying, I have heard Allah's messenger as saying, the invoker of curse would neither be a witness nor an intercessor on the day of resurrection.
That one, the invoker of curse.
That's just one.
No, this hadith is talking about Li'an.
Yeah, which is the invoker of curse.
No. There's different words. Now, this is why it's important to be careful with the hadith.
Can you show us?
Yes.
Can you show us?
There's more than one hadith. There's a process in the Quran called Al-Li'an. This is what? Where it says witness or intercessor, yeah?
Witness or intercessor?
Yeah, so...
Which is what Muhammad's going to do.
No.
Wait, before we move on, can we clarify that Muhammad is the intercessor in judgment? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, so I think the question, you know the question, is quite clear that... The point is that Allah states that one who curses cannot be an intercessor.
Yeah.
Did you agree with that?
Where in the Quran?
In the hadith.
Where in the Quran?
I clearly didn't say the Quran.
You said Allah,
the hadith.
Allah states.
No, I'm saying Allah states.
Allah speaks.
No. Muhammad states.
Muhammad states. Oh, yes. Okay, and right. So Muhammad states.
Which is the hadith?
Allah states, right?
No. The hadith is from Muhammad's own words. Okay, this is a basic lesson.
Muhammad said.
Don't give us those.
Muhammad said. We know what Muhammad said.
Muhammad said. The basic lesson of the hadith is Muhammad's word.
Yes.
And then Allah's word is the Quran. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, sure. So
but there is something called Hadith Qudsi.
So do you agree with that though?
Which one?
So I'm saying, do you agree that if someone is an intercessor, okay, but one, if Muhammad, for example, we're speaking about, is an intercessor, he states himself that you cannot be an intercessor as well as one who curses.
Yeah.
So the two are contradictory.
What curse are you talking about?
It doesn't matter. It says if you invoke a curse, you can't be an intercessor.
What's the invoke?
But he did curse people. I can read you the curses.
You don't know what the word La'na is.
Let's read
what
the
What is a lamb in Arabic?
So are you saying there are different kind of curses?
Yeah. So what's the word? What does the word lamb mean?
I don't know Arabic. You tell us.
So if you don't know Arabic,
don't hide behind Arabic. You're gonna look like you're running away. I'm still gonna look.
Hold on.
All right. Don't hide.
No. Daniel, this is a waste of all of our time. You know that. You wasted his time.
Show Mohammed.
You know why?
We're not wasting
our
time.
No one's going to.
Can you
read
the hadith?
No, hold on. You can't read the hadith.
How about the cursing?
You don't know how to.
So you don't want to talk about it?
No, Aki. The word cursing. What is cursing?
I'm Aki. You didn't need to say it, did you?
He's gonna repent.
Going against halal.
Let's read it.
No, I don't know. Look.
Okay, let's read it for
what does it mean?
Anas bin Malik.
So he's gonna give you the sources. Yes. If it doesn't say the curse that you mean, show us
what is the word curse. What does the word curse mean?
Okay,
so what are you coming
we're
to
gonna look
at,
we're gonna look at. Tell
what
me
are you coming to me.
So I'm gonna ask you to explain if this is a curse or not. Okay.
Yes.
So Anas bin Malik reported that there was an orphan girl with Umm Sulaym, who was the mother of Anas. Allah's messenger saw that orphan girl and said, "Oh, it is you. You have grown young. May you not advance in years." That slave girl returned to Umm Sulaym weeping. Umm Sulaym said, "Oh daughter, what is the matter with you?" She said, "Allah's apostle has invoked a curse upon me, that I should not grow in age. And plus, I would never grow in age." Or she said, "In my length of my life." Umm Sulaym went out wrapping her head, dressed hurriedly, until she met Allah's messenger. He said to her, "Umm Sulaym, what is the matter with you?" She said, "Allah's apostle, you invoked curse upon my orphan girl." Now, the question I'm asking is this. We've read what the curse is.
Sahih Muslim 32.
Yes. Yeah, Umm Sulaym.
So the curse, let's read what the actual curse did. You have May you not advance in years. That slave girl returned. Yeah, so may you not advance in years. You're calling me Aki again. You love me that much. I'm not saying that Shahada today. I'm not saying Shahada. But what I'm saying
is
that
it's a curse. I understand your argument. I'll come back to you. The curse in the initial thing, in the initial hadith that you brought in, sort of Sahih Muslim. Let's, for the sake of argument, say it's cursing like la'na, like a la'na curse be upon you. In usul al-fiqh, do you know what this is? What's usul al-fiqh? You don't know? Okay, this has to be...
You're hiding behind Arabic, that's the problem.
No, it's not Arabic, this is not Arabic. Okay, this is a science. Science. Usul al-fiqh, there are three things. There's al-aam, Al-Mutlaq and Al-Muqayyad.
Yo, can you hear me?
Are you with me here? Al-Aam, Al-Mutlaq and Al-Muqayyad. Forget about this mas'ala, because this... What I'm about to
see... Forget about
that. No. I'll come back to it in a second, but you need to understand how this works. Al-Aam, Al-Mutlaq and Al-Muqayyad. Let's say, for the sake of argument, that Al-Aam means a general thing, okay?
Now, sorry, are these curses?
No, you don't understand. This is a very complex thing which you need to wait for 2 minutes to learn, okay? Sorry to say
it.
You will learn. It's very important.
But you're saying that
listen to me. You have Al-Aam, Al-Mutlaq, and Al-Muqayyad. Now, Al-Aam is if the Quran states or the Hadith, it's a general principle, okay? If something is generally stated, respective to a plural entity usually. For example, in the Quran verse, "Qatil al-mushrikeen." Yes, kill the disbelievers. It's a general verse. Yes? Now, in order for a general verse not to be, or a hadith, not to be taken on general face value, there has to be something called a qarina. A qarina can take two forms. A qarina can either be something from the hadith or it can be something from the Quran. Okay? I'll give you an example. Allah says in the Quran, okay? He says, Qatilu al-Mushrikeen. He says, kill them this way, the pagans, for example. Yeah? This is a general verse. Now, if that was the only thing that was said in the Quran, we would have to kill all the disbelievers. Yes? We would have to kill all the disbelievers. How? Qatilu al-Ladina la yu'minuna billahi wa la bil yawmil akhir. You know, 929 that you always quote. Yeah? Yes?
Oh, you've watched our videos. You're fans.
No, I'm not.
Just about you.
Yes, of course. Now, this is a principle that will help you understand Islam, how to understand it scholastically, okay? So, Godwin, I would listen to you if you were here, right? Now, a qarina is some kind of an evidence that does what you call takhsis. Takhsis means narrowing down. This is very well known to all of the ulama of Islam, all of the scholars of Islam know this. So, for example, if the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, he said in Sahih Muslim, the one who
does shafa'ah,
who does intercession, has to come be the curse. Now, if the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself cursed, because he and what he does is what he does, what he says, and what he does get iqrar of, meaning what he endorses, is sunnah, this would be a necessary exemption. The same thing with the Quran, where it says qatil al-mushrikeen, kill the disbelievers, whatever. If that was the only verse in the Quran, that would be what it means. But because we know Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not act like that with all the disbelievers, he had Jews and Christians, etc. And there are other verses, yes? What you do is you do jama' adillah. Jama' adillah means you bring all the evidence together and you see murad al-shari'ah. You see what Allah intended with all those verses together. So we say, okay, Allah intended, if you put all those verses and hadith together, for instance...
Two minutes has elapsed, but please round up.
In this case,
you're not engaging.
This can't be...
But round up what you're saying.
I'm just saying...
Engage.
What I'm saying is, let's say for the sake of argument, that you're absolutely right.
Yes.
The hadith means this.
Yes,
no problem. If Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad, he said something, it was a general statement. For example, he says, I'll give you an example.
We've given you
examples of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, there's many things he said, don't do, and then he did it. Yes?
But we're not talking about when he quoted
this. No.
That he literally cursed.
Listen to me. This is a principle that
you will learn. I don't want you to lose the audience, and I don't want you to lose us.
Let me come back.
Okay.
Let me learn it.
So we've seen a literal curse.
No.
Yes?
One second.
Here's... So the question is this.
Listen again.
Why is it in this verse?
Wait.
Listen to this verse. So why is it here? Let me just read to you what Sahih Muslim says. It says, Abu Huraira reported, it was said to Allah's Messenger, invoke curse upon the polytheist. Whereupon he said, I have not been sent as an invoker of curse, but I have been sent as a mercy. Yes? But let me read this one just above that. Sahih Muslim, it says, Dada reported on the authority of Abu Dada saying, I heard Allah's Messenger as saying, the invoker of curse would neither be a witness nor intercessor on the day of the resurrection. See, Sahih Muslim.
Yes, yes.
Wait, let me finish.
Yes,
32:6-8:3.
Yes.
No, now, the problem is this. Yes.
No, he said that.
You have claimed.
No, that's everywhere.
Wait. You have claimed that Muhammad is an intercessor on Judgment Day.
Yeah.
But Muhammad, by his own very words,
has said that someone
who invokes curse cannot be an intercessor. Muhammad has contradicted himself.
Yes, no.
And has shown that he cannot be a prophet.
Let me explain to you.
Do you understand?
I understand what you're saying, but let me explain to you. Once again, what is the sunnah? The sunnah is what we are meant to follow, yeah? What we are meant to follow as Muslims. The Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is nothing. Wallahi, I can give you. If you ask me right now, give me a 5 minute thing. I will give you a.
We only begin with a 2 minute.
Listen,
I'm not David Wood. I'm not David Wood. Yeah.
Godwin.
Boy.
Sorry. Godwin.
Hey, yeah, Godwin.
Godwin. I was gonna say to you that if you give me 5 minutes, I will give you 100. I can give you 100 verses. Yes, me. I can give you 100 verses where there is a general rule and there are exceptions to the general rule. It's called Aam and Khas. The same thing applies with the hadith.
So there's Aam is general.
The first hadith is general. There are, of course, there are people that La'an Allah al-Yahud wa al-Nasara. I'm helping you here. Let me help you. Forget this hadith. Let me help you, yes? The hadith says La'an Allah al-Yahud wa al-Nasara ta'khudhu masaj anbiya'ihim khubur. Khubur anbiya'ihim masajid. The hadith says, may the curse be on the Jews and the Christians that they took them as for a reason. That they took the graves of their prophets as masajid, as places of worship, yes? So the point is this, is that there are general rules and then there are exceptions to the rule.
No, we understand that.
No problem.
Muhammad, we understand that. Show us that this is general.
That's it.
And show us that way, this is not specific.
No.
This is general, show us.
This is a science. It's very difficult for you to understand because it's a complex science. But here's
you're making it complex.
No, but you need to learn.
Because you're not dealing with the issue.
Godwin, I shouldn't be teaching you this.
Maybe I should get money. Give me the money. It's not religion.
Give me money for this.
Money?
Yes, you should give me money. Jizya. You give me the jizya because I
jizya.
I'm teaching you.
He's not teaching you jizya. This is cheating. How much do we owe you?
Yeah. 25 minutes.
15 minutes.
Yeah.
150.
150.
Yes, please.
We're not Sharia law.
Give me the jizya, brother.
So Muhammad, we actually do.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? I'm dealing with it. Okay. I'm saying that in usul.
It's all right.
Can we keep talking?
Yeah. We have. Why are you talking to me? Keep talking.
Keep talking.
You don't want to listen.
I'm asking
you. I thought you were a sincere guy. Do you know what? I haven't spoken to you for
you
how many?
Gonna
how many?
No,
I'm not gonna run.
Okay, go.
I'm saying to you, I haven't spoken to you for many months, yeah?
For many months?
Or something, yeah? Or maybe many years even, I don't know. But I thought maybe today you came to me in a nice way. I thought, you know what? Allah changes the hearts. You know what, like, you can't hear
me. Allah changes the hearts, you know? No. Jesus changes the hearts.
Yahweh
doesn't change
the hearts. Okay, we're getting
on
topic.
Yahweh changed the hearts.
Still support.
Brother in humanity.
I'm going to make life easier for you, okay? I'm going to tell you that there are verses in the Quran that are general. Yes.
And there are verses specific.
Yes.
Show us.
Do you know how to find out what's... Okay, perfect. Okay. How do you ascertain what's something specific? That's the question, yeah?
Show us this one.
How do you ascertain? That's the question. You have, we call it al-fadhil umum, yeah? Al-fadhil umum are phrases of generality. And then you have sighat al-tahsis. You have things which necessitate something specific, yeah? So for example, if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did something that was in opposition to a general rule, if he did it himself, this would automatically render that situation specific.
But you need to show us this.
That's it. So we're going to show us then.
You're giving us general.
Okay,
now.
So here the question is, did the Prophet Muhammad, did he curse Umm Sulaym?
So he cannot be an intercessor. He said himself, so you cannot be an intercessor. Okay, so why are you following this guy who contradicts himself?
You don't understand how the principles of jurisprudence work.
Don't touch his camera.
Right, Mohammed, come.
Okay, Mohammed,
don't run away. is going to come.
You don't need to record anymore, bro.
Don't touch the camera. It's not yours.
No, they don't want to be recording.
Okay. Then they need to leave in the speaker's corner.
Should we follow Mohammed?
No, man, he's confused. Let's just wrap up.
Let's wrap up. I'm going to talk about
what did we say? Mohammed Hijab is confused.
Stop, yeah? Should we find out if Mohammed wants to continue? Does this fan if he wants to continue?
Godwin, why is it that Mohammed
Why is it that Muhammad then says to Allah?
Yes, Aki.
Wait, hold on, listen.
Yes.
Why is it Muhammad then says to Allah? Every time I curse someone, okay, I want you to make it a blessing. I want you to purify that curse.
No, bro. Muhammad made a deal with Allah.
Godwin, not even Allah making the deal with Muhammad.
I understand your point. But no, honestly, I want to tell you something, right? This is me being sincere with you guys and being honest with you guys, yeah?
Which is good.
No, honestly, I want to totally give you a professional answer, do you get me?
Professional, like I want to give you an academic answer.
And I know you're clever enough to understand it. Honestly, I know you are. And if you can't, please work with me, yeah? There's a difference between the Quran and the New Testament. I'll tell you what the difference is, yeah?
The New Testament?
Yeah.
I'll come to it, I swear.
These are principles, if you learn them, yes, Godwin, you will understand how to approach the Quran more, yeah? And you know, to be honest with you, I don't have to do this. No. I'm doing this because it will help you understand.
Because you're getting the jizya.
Well, I'll get the jizya. You have to give me the jizya. They're giving the jizya. Okay? No, I don't.
By the way, are you still going to debate David Woods?
Oh yeah, of course.
So why would you? Why is it that you want to debate David Woods? You don't want to debate. You don't want to continue this conversation.
I am going to continue.
So you're not going to go away.
I'm speaking to you now, man.
Okay, so Godwin.
What I'm saying to you is this, yeah. The New Testament, the way it works is that you have stories, etc., accounts, narratives, whatever. The Quran is a little bit different. Do you know why? Because the Quran is to be interpreted as guidance, etc., but it's also a legal framework. Like, you know, the same way as a constitution will be interpreted and laws. The Quran is like that. Yeah, so that's why you have Sharia law. Sharia law is an extension of the Quran in a sense, because it's what's extrapolated from the Quran and what how laws are derived.
No hadith.
And the hadith as well, of course. Yeah,
we read hadith. We didn't read.
I'm not talking about this mess. I'm going to come to it if you want.
But if
you understand the principles, yeah, then you will understand everything.
I promise you.
Specific.
I'm
dealing
with
God.
But you're not dealing with
God. I swear, if you understand this, you will understand a lot. I'm telling you.
Give us the principle of the hadith.
Give us the principle.
لا يتعلم العلم مستحي أو متكبر. The author of the Sahaba says there's two people that don't learn. Someone who's a shy person and someone who's an arrogant person. Now I'm not saying this because I'm, you know, trying to sanctimoniously arrogate to you. I'm not. I'm saying this to you because I think.
Is it because we want answers?
No. I do think.
We want answers.
Godwin.
And so you don't like when we mean questions.
Listen, let's be sincere with each other, honestly, yeah?
Godwin, you're not being sincere. You're not letting me speak.
Okay?
I swear.
You know, how many give him a little bit more
just
time?
Just give me a minute.
What I'm saying is, if
we realize that the Quran is it has to be interpreted and the hadith legally in a sense, yeah? Just in the same way as constitutions and laws are, we have to also appreciate that there are what we call rules of extrapolation or derivation of principles from Quran and Sunnah. So, for instance, I'm giving you, this is something that, forget about this mess, it's nothing to me. Well, it's nothing, it's nothing.
So it's not, these hadiths don't matter.
Godwin, I'm telling you.
Are you first?
No.
You said it, please.
I'm telling you this mas'ala, I can give you 100, and I'm right now, I'm making your life easier, brother, okay? I'm making your life easier. Do you know why? I'm making your life easier. I'm telling you, I can get you, if you ask me now, I can give you 1,000 examples, yeah? Of things like this. The general rule is this, Yeah, and this is my premise, okay? And this is how they extract laws from the Quran and Sunnah. You have ayat and ahadith, you have verses of the Quran and you have hadith, which are general, or I call the am, okay? The only way these verses, which are am, can be made into khas is with a qalina.
In 1 minute.
Yeah, I know, but if you allow
can
me.
Can we respond to
no, but you don't know what I'm talking about.
But the thing is,
you don't know. You said you need a minute.
All due respect.
I don't know, man.
Listen. All due respect.
How can I?
It sounds like, wait.
How can I teach
you've
you?
Given us your reflection.
If you don't allow me, man.
All due respect, you sound like you're waffling. Yes?
Okay,
you're
Godwin.
Godwin,
you're
clearly cursing. If you say to Allah, purify my curses.
Godwin, let me finish it. He's
making a deal.
Godwin, please. I'm doing
like
this.
Like a jizya deal.
Yeah, jizya.
So,
we took the jizya. No problem.
So, why?
And we'll take the jizya again.
So,
it will happen again in the future when the Mahdi comes. It will 100% happen again.
Okay.
Watch out. So, let's pray. Yeah. Never come.
The jizya was
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what the jizya is?
Okay, so.
Anyway.
So, the issue is this.
Godwin.
Deal with the issue. If you can't, just say. I don't know.
Okay,
I don't
no
understand
problem.
This.
I don't know. I don't
it's a contradiction.
Yes.
Mom I don't know. Whatever you want
to
do.
I want Jesus to be my life.
Yes. Oh, fine.
Say this kind of thing.
They would appreciate it.
Godwin, no problem. If you want to go, you can go. I'm doing this out of the kindness of my own heart. I'm teaching you something you have no idea
of. You're not being very kind.
No, but that's how it is.
You're not dealing with the issue.
I'm teaching you something.
We will come to you.
You're not being very kind.
Alright, I'm going to leave you guys. If you don't let me speak, I'm going
to
go.
We're giving you time to speak over there 2-3 minutes. The only time to give you another minute.
Here's the answer.
And you're still waffling.
Okay, if you think it's waffling, that's your, because you don't understand it.
So you're
not making sense.
Your answer is, this is general.
Yes.
This is not specific. You guys need to go deeper and give me a specific ayah.
No, you don't know how to. The way it works is this, yeah?
Oh, we don't know how to do it.
No, yeah.
Do you know how to do it?
Yes, I know how to do it.
Okay, can you give us 1 minute?
Yes.
Lecture on that, just 1 minute.
He loves preaching. Let him preach.
The way it works is this, yeah?
Another 1 minute.
Okay, I'm going to repeat myself a little bit, yeah? There are verses and ahadith in the Quran and the Sunnah, yeah? Which are general. And then you'll find that which goes against those verses in the Quran, which are general. These are called specific.
Okay.
What does that show us? That shows us it can mean many things. For example, if something is like an amr, this is very difficult stuff. But if something is an amr, yeah, if something is a command, it becomes wajib. For example, if Allah says something, do this, don't do this, it's wajib. You have to do it. For example, and then if there is a qarina, if there's a specific exception to that rule, it shows us potentially that this can go down from amr to istihbab. The point is wajib to istihbab. The point is this, is that there are general verses and there are specific verses.
Okay.
Yes? The specific verses can either be specific to the individual, i.e. in this case Prophet Muhammad or whatever, or it can be specific generally. So any verse you find or any hadith you find, not just this one, any one you want, yeah? Which is general. Fight the Jews and the Christians, etc. Which are general, there are general verses. This is general.
For a minute, you said we can do a minute.
Okay, we understand your point.
Yes.
What are you trying to do to your hadith? Because it sounds like you're trying to butcher your hadith. Give us an example. You said you can give us 1,000 examples. You haven't even given us one.
Oh, of what?
You haven't even given us one.
Thank you.
Yes.
I'll give you one example. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أمرت أن أقاتل الناس حتى يقولوا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد محمد رسول الله. فإن فعلوا ذلك, first of all, it says that I have been commanded to kill the people, and الناس. حتى يقولوا, until they say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله.
Again, another one.
Let me do تخصيص of it first, because otherwise, I leave أخي. So obviously, if it was الناس and it meant all the people in the world, then he would have killed the Muslims as well.
Okay. Until they say Shahada.
You're trying to sneak off with that one.
No problem.
That's specific.
You didn't give him general. You're messing him up. Don't talk.
Listen, you're messing him up.
Don't
do
this. Don't help him out. You're messing him up.
Who will help you?
الَّذِينَ قَالُوا لَهُمْ
Who will help you?
So hold on. Same thing in the Quran. Is
these are helping
Godwin.
Well, we
if you don't
minute.
Understand the principles, you're not gonna be able to. Are you, are you not going to listen? In the Quran it says,
we've read this. Al-Ladina
qala lahum nas inna
nas qad jama'a. Am I right to understand as an observer?
خلاص. Are you guys
Butchering Sahih Muslim, which already identified as the Sahih, and then just telling us actually that's for the general and then Pacifics playing all those gentle word games, and confirming Muhammad cursed people, and then made a deal with Allah, turned them to the blessings, and then he's identified as the intercessor, and then people who curse, they call intercessor. So Muhammad turned up in 7th century, made a claim الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمْ مِنْ
That Muhammad Hijab is confused. He's confused, he's trying to confuse us. Because we are specifically asking from Sahih Muslim that Muhammad is cursing Ibn Salim, whatever the name is. Tongue breaker name. And he's cursing that. And another hadith says in Sahih Muslim that if you curse, you cannot be an intercessor. So Muhammad cannot be your intercessor at the day of judgment. Now Muhammad Hijab is saying, no, this one is general. You gotta get a specific one. Okay, show us a specific verse that we are wrong and refute this. But he's not. He's actually going general and he's not answering the question. That's why we kept hammering it, but he's not answering it. Just like Ali Dawood.
Okay, and on top of that, he's throwing the hadith under the bus. He's talking about these generals and specifics. Where does he get these terms from?
I don't know.
Clearly, it looks like, clearly, in the text, it shows that Muhammad was making a deal with Allah. You're saying, listen, when I curse people, turn it into purification, turn it into a blessing. Now, where do we have, where can a human being have the audacity
and authority
to say to God that, you know what, when I curse someone, turn it into a blessing? What that shows is that clearly, what that clearly states is that we have a problem in regards to Muhammad.
Yes.
Because Muhammad is a false prophet, and what he's trying to do, because he sins, he's trying to use those sins, trying to cover it up, and conveniently, he wants those sins that he carries out to be covered up by Allah, turning it into a blessing.
Yes.
And there's a major problem with that. And so I would encourage Muhammad Hijab.
Hijab,
yeah, whatever his name is, that if he cannot make sense of Islam, come to a better role model.
His name the same Jesus yesterday, Christ. Today, and forevermore.
Yeah, what's his
name? His name is
Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, viewers. God bless.